Hello world, it's Ritik Sinha and today we'll do a little web project. We'll create a Lumos effect with HTML and CSS. So let's get started.
I'm working on a game, Harry Potter and the Horcrux Hunt. Definitely, this game is inspired by Harry Potter. I will not tell the whole concept of the game. That will be a spoiler. So if you want to find out, then consider liking and subscribing. And also, you can guess in the comment section. I will definitely give a shout out to the correct guess. This project is just a part of the game, or you can say it is the landing page of the game. We'll create a Lumos effect. Lumos is the magic spell which Harry Potter used to light up his magic wand. And we are creating something similar, hence we call it Lumos effect. First, I created this background with my little knowledge of Photoshop. I watched some YouTube tutorials and came up with this background. I know this is not perfect and I may replace it in near future. And this will be one of my assets for this project. And the second thing I will create that will be replaced with my default cursor. Okay, now let's code it. First, I will create two files, index.html and style.css. Let's work on index.html. The first thing, I will create a HTML structure. Then I will bring a jQuery using its CDN. So let's copy it from their website. Now the next step is to link this style sheet. Inside body tag, we'll create a section with a class name. That's it for now. We'll come back later to add jQuery script. Let's work on CSS. We'll select the section with the class name. Then we'll set its background property by providing background URL and set its background size property to cover and position into its center and height will be full 100 VH. Then we will use root selector to select the root element of the HTML file, that is HTML tag, and change the cursor with the custom cursor. Then we'll declare two variables, x and y. It will be coordinates. We will keep its default value and we will use it with var function. Now it's time to use before selector. It insert something before the content of each selected elements. Inside it, we define some CSS properties. Content, display width, height, position as fixed, and pointer events as none. Now let's work on the main thing, background. We'll set to its as a radial gradient, and the first value is shape and the second value is size, and then position. In position, we'll use our x and y variables and later we'll change it with our jQuery. Now let's define color. Start color as RGB 0 0 0 and 0% opacity, then RGB 0 0 0 and 0.5 with 80%, I guess. Then RGB 0 0 0 and 0.95 with 100%. Okay, that's it for CSS. Now let's write some JavaScript code. Let's define a script tag. Then we'll create a function which will calculate or capture the screen coordinates and we'll set the CSS variable. So let's do it. Now it's time to listen for the event that we capture from the mouse movement, and then we'll fire this function that we have created above here. And job will be done. Now let's track the touchpad as well of the laptops, and in the same way we'll fire this function. Okay, now let's test it.
That's it for today. If you like this video, then consider liking and subscribing, and also drop me a message on Instagram or Twitter. Stay healthy, stay safe, and keep learning. Goodbye for now.